I have a feeling you're gonna die a virgin light.
I hope you people are happy. I was enjoying my life in the afterlife, and you people brought me back for part two of this video. Shame on you. I hate you all with a burning passion. Let's not waste any time. Let's just get to it already, shall we?
Hey everyone, Rushing Fire.
Oh boy, now it's time for part two.
Welcome to my second part of my Burning Gear review. Like the title displays, if you haven't watched the first part of this review, go watch it. Do not watch this video first.
No, of course not.
Spoiled. So yeah, anyway, back to my review. Now I explain
the
different varieties of bosses.
Holy shit.
Now for the bosses in this game,
yeah,
you have a different variety of different bosses.
Okay, didn't you already say that?
The bosses are huge and require a lot of strategy.
They do? Oh my god! Really? Wow, thanks for pointing that out. I didn't know that.
Egyptian Lynx thing.
It's a Sphinx.
Some bosses can be a huge pain in the ass to beat.
They can?
But with a lot of practice and strategy, you can
overcome.
But however, there is one particular boss in this game.
There is?
I've always had trouble beating.
What boss is that?
This particular boss.
That boss? Is that really what the boss looks like in the game?
Let me tell you.
Come on, why can't you show any footage of you fighting the boss? Come on! Where's the footage? I want to see the footage. Seriously. I mean, come on! How do I know how hard this boss is if you're not showing any gameplay footage of you fighting her? What the hell? This is so pointless. Oh my god, what the fuck?
Kick your ass.
Yeah, well, I can't really see that happening because you're not showing it. All you're showing is this picture.
Well, I don't know why he isn't showing footage of it, but is it really worth complaining about? Frankly, I mean, I have reason to complain that I'm trying to do a commentary on this video, and it's a lot harder than it seems. In fact, look how long it took me to actually get around to making this thing. That is something to complain about. Not showing a bit of footage for a boss battle. I mean, come on. And could you get any more annoying when it comes to complaining, dude? Honestly, I'd rather hear Joshua trying to do a commentary on this than you. I'm dead serious.
Speaking of bosses while we're still on the subject, every once in a while in a few other worlds in every world, you'll occasionally also run into this one
particular boss called Nitro.
So yeah, he's basically like Bowerman's answer to Sir Meta Knight.
Sir Meta Knight? He doesn't even look like Meta Knight.
In the Kirby franchise.
What the fuck?
His name is not to be confused with the certain YouTuber
called Nitroxus. Okay, so I'm not gonna confuse his name with Nitroxus.
Every once in a while, you'll fight this boss called Nitroxus.
Alright, so you're gonna show footage of you fighting this boss, but you're not gonna show footage of you fighting the cat boss you were bitching about earlier.
First, he starts
that's kind of odd. Whatever.
Once you fight him in more Nitro.
Oh my god, really? He gets harder every time you fight him? No shit, Sherlock. Like that's supposed to happen.
Eight directions, which is hard
That's gonna suck.
And eventually, in later levels, he'll start shooting red bums
at you. Oh my god, he's gonna shoot red bums at you?
Each Nitro battle is harder than the last. At first, he starts out with simple ice cubes.
Oh, wow, simple ice cubes. Those mean you beat, right?
Shields and green protector shields at you.
Oh, no, not the shields.
He'll dodge your bombs. It will be hard to hit him.
Oh, crap.
He starts shooting red bombs at
you. Oh, no, not the red bombs. Well, at least doesn't send any fudge packers or magnet Amy's after you. That's a good thing.
And he's after the secret disc for his own race.
Oh, he is? I wonder what he wants to do with that secret disc. Oh my.
Although this God. Is a good game, one minor complaint
what
I have
is
about
the complaint
this game
you have about this
the
game?
Lack of a two-player multiplayer.
Oh,
mode,
lack of multiplayer.
Which is one of
course.
The best parts in any Bomberman game.
Oh my God, that robot's having a seizure.
But hey, that's okay. As long as this
yeah,
game's
sure
good.
Is.
The graphics are good.
Oh, yes, the graphics are very good.
Outstanding.
Yes, outstanding.
This game, while it may not have a multiplayer mode,
yeah, of
it's
course
certainly
not.
A hell lot better than that particular Xbox 360
what
game.
What game would that
which
be?
I don't care to mention.
You're not going
to
mention it?
Yeah, Bomberman
Wait,
Zero.
You said you weren't going to mention it earlier, but you did. Huh.
Also, another minor complaint I have about this
what?
Game is some of the snowboarding levels can be a pain in the ass.
They can?
Because of the very loose controls. But they're
really?
Not too bad. But
okay,
at least
you're not
the snowboard levels
then.
In this game are a hell lot better than that
what?
Other particular
Oh my God, Sonic the Disaster Gamer fan! I hear this game is with the voice actor!
I would insert a Nostalgia Critic clip of him punching the camera while saying that funny a few times because that describes your humor perfectly. However, I am going to save the viewers time here and frankly just move on because frankly, we're all getting sick of me going on a downward spiral, and we're sick of you trying to take the piss out of this reviewer. Please stop. I beg you, now. Otherwise, it won't be me that gets killed at the end of the video this time.
Damn you, Griffith! I hate your voice! Griffith!
Eat it,
Scare fans! I hate this game!
Broken game ever
it's called Song
made.
The Fucking Disaster! God. Why do you have to show that?
So, anyway, aside from all the two
yeah.
minor complaints I have about the game,
aside from your
so
complaints,
yeah, this is still a
what
good
thing
game
of the
to
game?
Check out for your N64 library.
Yeah.
So, yeah, if you're new to Bomberman, check this one out.
Okay, so if you're new to
Bomberman,
check it out, okay.
I mean, Bomberman Beginners, yeah.
Bomberman
so, yeah.
Beginners, huh?
One of the first Bomberman games to allow platforming jumping.
Oh my God,
like
platform jumping in a Bomberman game?
Man,
holy
or
crap!
Cute or Kirby or anything like that. So
yeah,
with the lack of a multiplayer two-player
yeah,
mode,
yeah, lacks multiplayer.
So
big
what can
whoop.
I say? Well,
yeah,
I have to give this game
what's the
a
rating?
4 out of 5.
A 4 out of 5,
so,
huh?
It's still a good
is that
game.
That good, really?
Mind. Awesome
wow.
game. Check it out.
Okay.
Even if it doesn't have multiplayer mode.
Yeah,
it's
I know, it doesn't have multiplayer, whatever.
Bomberman Act Zero.
Oh yeah, Bomberman Act Zero
yeah,
for the
Bomberman
360.
Zero.
God, that
so,
game's
yeah.
awful.
Bomberman Hero, a good game.
Yes, Bomberman
so,
Hero's a good game. He highly recommends
4
it.
4 out of 5. Thank you for watching this review.
Oh yeah, I really enjoyed this review.
Good afternoon to everyone.
Not.
And I also enjoyed your review. Not. Overall, this video was awful. It really is. I'm sorry, Shadowblaze, but you're not funny. Please stop trying to be funny. No one is finding you entertaining. In fact, it makes me want to kill you. It really does. I feel like taking a rifle, the same one I blew myself up with, and, well, doing the same to you. As a matter of fact, hey, Total Domination, care to give me his address? Because, frankly, I'm going Shadowblaze hunting. Thank you for watching. This is NotFrost95, signing out. Alright, so according to Total Domination, Shadowblaze should be around here. Okay. And that, ladies and gentlemen, is why you don't send me on a downward spiral leading to suicide. I will get you back. Afros95, signing out, truly this time.